Hi Dygmates, and welcome to a new Ergobits. Today we have delicious bits to share. The race to mass production is on track and we'll have the first keyboards ready to ship by the end of September. We have released Bazecor 1.5.0 with a new layout editor that's more intuitive to use for everyone. And we have updates about the new 2.0 firmware for the Defy. So let's just jump into it. Okay, so let's start with the race to mass production, which will be short. Everything is still going as planned. We've been ironing out some small details like the stickers that go on the side legs for the tenting or the shades of gray for the base of the silver race. Arturo, one of our mechanical engineers, is currently traveling to China to oversee a pilot run of 50 keyboards, which should be ready to ship by the end of September. That pilot run is to ensure that the assembly and the quality control processes are on point. Then we have a 2-week buffer to make any necessary adjustments. Afterward, we'll start assembling around 500 keyboards a week. That means the first 1,000 keyboards should ship by the end of October. The rest will follow in the next weeks, shipping all pre-orders by the end of November, just in time for my birthday. So feel free to send me a gift at Talking about pre-orders, if you're considering getting a Raise 2, don't take too long to decide and take advantage of the 10% pre-sale discount. If you're indecisive about what color to get, I get you. They're just both absolutely gorgeous. So maybe get both. One for the office and one for home. Next up, we have the latest Bazecor release, 1.5.0, which has an all-new layout editor that we designed to be more intuitive for everyone. Basically, we've merged the standard and single views from previous versions. The new layout editor allows for a larger keyboard representation while making all the features readily accessible in menus that are easier for newcomers to understand. We also changed how dual function keys are implemented. Now you can add a key on tap to modifiers or layer shifts instead of having to add a dual function, which nobody really understood. Check out this other video if you want to know all about it. To download the latest Bazecor and to check our roadmap, go to dygma.com/bazecor. Our devs have also been working on the new 2.0 firmware for the Defy and the new 1.0 firmware for the Race 2. We are super happy to announce that after many months of development and weeks of internal testing, we are about to start the testing with our private beta testers group. Once we iron out the bugs they find, we'll release a public beta, which should be ready next month at the latest. This new firmware includes a complete rework of how the keyboard's different chips communicate, which should help with the connectivity issues that some users have been facing. It also includes a highly awaited feature, more configuration options for dual function keys that should help fine-tune their behavior when using home row modifiers. The critical new setting is minimum hold timeout, which, when set at 80 or 90 milliseconds, prevents the hold function from triggering when rolling your keys. We all do this, and it's the biggest annoyance when using home row modifiers. Moving on to setups we envy. We wanted to share Anorak's setup, which has the Defy commanding 2 MacBooks and an iPad. That's pretty cool. As for the inspiring layer, this month we can share no other but Mikkel's Lightroom layer, an example of how to transform your keyboard into a macro pad. We made a video on this a few weeks ago, so make sure to check that out. And that's it for today's Ergobits, guys. Enjoy the last 2 days of summer or winter if you live down the southern hemisphere. And don't forget to get your race too before the pre-sale discount ends. Bye!